Welcome to Truck Trailer Pro. Today we're going to discuss your road test. So after you take and do your pre-trip and pass, then you have maneuvers. After you've taken and done your maneuvers and pass, the last thing we have is the road test. Now on the road test, it lasts about 20, 25 minutes, and there are a few things that you're going to have to do. You're going to have to make certain left turns. You're going to have to make so many right turns. You're going to have to go across railroad tracks. You're going to have to go into a school zone. You'll also have to make an emergency stop. There are some rules and some automatic things that you can fail. So there are some automatic fails while you're driving. Exceeding the speed limit is an automatic fail. Running a red light or a stop sign is an automatic fail. Hitting a curb left or right is an automatic fail. Impeding traffic is an automatic fail. Not turning on your directionals to change lanes is an automatic fail. Let me go back one to impeding traffic. Impeding traffic means cutting someone off and not leaving a space so that they have to hit their brakes to slow down. Getting in and out of your cab without, you've got to face the truck. You've got to face the truck going in, and you've got to face the truck coming out of the cab. That is an automatic fail too. And I believe that would be it. So let's get inside, go on the road, and let's do some maneuvers.
Okay, you can start.
Okay, we're gonna go on the road. Make sure you adjust your seat. Make sure your seat belt's ready. Make sure you adjust your mirrors. And let's go. We're in a parking lot right now, so all I'm doing now is just leaving the parking lot to get out to the road. When you drive, one of the things that the examiners are looking for is when you turn your wheel, it's hand over hand. They don't want you to
turn right here.
They don't want you to palm the steering wheel. So I've got my right turn signal on. I'm going to stop behind the white line, if there was one, and there's not. So now I'm going to just wait for traffic, because I'm a little bit longer than the rest of these cars, and there's a pole on the corner. So I'm going to pull out. I'm going to wait till my shoulder clears that pole in that lane, and then I'm going to turn right. As I'm doing it, I'm looking at my mirrors on the right hand side, and then I'm getting my lane. As I'm in my lane, I'm gonna stay in between the two lines. I'm gonna watch the speed limit, which is 35. And on the test, they want you to watch and look at your mirrors every 4 to 6 seconds. And you'll have to do that to stay in between the lines. And my examiner's not going to tell me much or talk to me much, because he's watching every move that I make. There are pedestrians on the side. You've got to watch for them, because you have kids and young adults. Make sure they don't jump out in front of you. watch my speed. Turning up ahead, so I'm gonna take my foot off the gas just in case he jumped in front of me so I would be ready. And there, I've got signs for pedestrians, so I just have to be careful. Scan my 15 seconds up ahead. And we're coming up on a light.
What is the speed limit here?
35. They will be asking you questions as you drive. Speed limit, if you go under a bridge, what's the height of the bridge? Those are the two most common questions. I see the light is red in front of me, so I'm going to take my foot off the gas and just wait and see what it does.
We will make a right turn at the lights.
Right turn at the light. I'm going to turn on my blinker. And we're coming up on a McDonald's and a school zone. There's the school zone. I must slow down. I'm going to get into the right lane. When there is no kids out, you keep the regular speed limit unless the light is flashing. If there are kids around, you're to go 35. See the white line? We don't have to stop because we have a green light. But we do have to watch the mirrors and take this curve. We will be going into the opposite lane because our truck is longer than a car.
Make a lane change to the left.
Make a lane change to the left. I would turn on my left turn signal. I'll look at all my mirrors, my hood mirror plus my both mirrors. Make sure I'm absolutely clear before I make my lane change. The car in front of me.
We will turn left here.
Left here. Turn on the blinker. Get in my left turn lane. Now stay about a car length and a half. You're supposed to stop behind the white line. If you don't stop behind the white line like I was doing, anticipating traffic, then you need to tell the examiner, I was anticipating traffic, but do not back up. That is an automatic fail if you back up. But I might have to eat some points because I am sitting on the white line. But I will observe my turn up here on the left, and I'll have to pull out and make a nice, pretty sharp turn to the left. And I've got the arrow, look both ways. And I'll drive straight into the intersection and then make my hand overhand turn. I'll go a little bit on the white line before I come back. Stay in my lane. I'll check my mirrors to the right for my oncoming traffic. And I have a sharp curve ahead. It doesn't give me how many miles per hour I should be, but I am a truck. So whatever it is, I'm gonna go very slow because it's a pretty sharp turn. That's why we have the orange lights. I'm gonna stay in the middle of my lane. I've got a yield sign. Go straight, turn on my blinker to go to the left. Make sure I'm not impeding traffic. And move over into my lane. Turn off my blinker. limit here is 55, 60. Speed limit is 60. Every 4 to 6 seconds.
We will make an emergency stop right about our school.
Right here?
A little bit further.
Okay.
Yes.
So I'm going to turn on my blinker to go to the right. I'll pull over and make sure both my tractor and trailer are on the right side of the highway. I'll stop. Put it in neutral. Set my brakes. Turn on my emergency flashers. Right here. And that is an emergency stop.
Okay, now you can go back on the road.
Okay. So, turn off my emergency flashers, turn on my flasher going left. Put it in drive, and I'm going to wait for traffic. Yeah, and undo my brakes. On emergency stop, I'll speed up.
Then after you get back on the road, we will make a right turn at the next exit.
I do not want to impede traffic, so I'll just slowly go. Since we're going to be at the next exit, I just have to go straight ahead. Here we are at the exit.
And at the lights, we will make a left turn.
Left turn. And when you stop behind traffic, you stop a car length or a car and a half length from the car in front of you to give yourself plenty of room if something happened to the car in front of you for you to turn. Also, on your road test, you do not turn right on red. Once you get your CDLs, you can turn right on red. But for the test and for your permit, you do not turn right on red. We got the green light. Check my mirrors on both sides, and then I will go to the right lane. But I also just saw the sign that the right lane ends, so I'm going to have to come back to the left lane, and I've got quite a bit of traffic behind me, so I will just wait. Now I don't. I go back to the left lane. Train.
What is the speed limit here?
I don't know what the speed limit is here. I don't know what the speed limit is here. See, those are the questions they're going to ask you on your test. You got to make sure you're paying attention. And we've got the electronic lights, the red lights, so we are going to have to wait for the train.
How is the hand position? Like this or like that?
It's supposed to be like this.
9-3 or?
It's supposed to be 9-3 or 8-4.
Okay.
But I guess when I went to school, it was 10-2.
Oh.
So that's why I'm used to doing 10-2. But I'm glad you brought that up. Because
yeah, I will ask you a couple more different signs.
Okay.
Here, should I ask you what happens if you're stuck at the railroad?
Yeah, you can. Or I'll mention the sign.
If you mention better, because on the exam they don't ask it.
Okay. Okay, traffic's moving. We're coming up on the railroad tracks. As you approach the railroad tracks, you would need to slow down. We don't have to stop unless the lights are on or the flashing lights on. You slow down, you look both ways, make sure nothing is coming. And then you keep going. You don't stop on the tracks. And if you are stuck or something happens and you do get stuck on the tracks, the first thing you do is stop, get out of your vehicle, take your phone with you, and call. There's usually a placard right under the crossbook sign or right over by the railroad sign or the lights. It'll tell you the number, the track that you're on, the location, and the emergency number to call. If there is no number, you call 911 and tell them where you're at. Give them a location. We're coming up on a red light. And here is our white line, which we should stop behind. And normally, you stop behind it so you can see it. If you can see it, the instructor can see it. Another thing, while you're driving, the best way to hold your hand so that you're comfortable is a 9-3, which is right across from each other, or a 8-4, which is a little bit down. I'm looking at both ways, and I'm looking. Making sure I stay in my lane.
What's the sign says here?
It says 25 miles per hour. And it also says truck route.
And we will make a right turn at the lights.
Right turn at the light.
That's a sharp turn.
Mm-hmm. What you want to do when you make a right turn, this is actually two lanes. You can take over both the lanes, but you've got to really watch the right lane and make sure nobody comes around you when you're making this turn. And watch the curb, because you don't want to hit the curb. That's an automatic fail. You had to watch the car in front of you and on the side of you. That's why you just take it extremely slow. There's no points for being safe and making other people safe. Watch the cars on the right. Stay in your lane. Never change lanes when you're in the middle of an intersection. Always wait till you get through the intersection before you change lanes.
Make a lane change to the right.
Making a lane change to the right. I've got a car in the back there, so I'm going to take my foot off the gas and let him pass. He's not in a hurry to pass. I think he's waiting for me, so maybe nope. Here he comes. There we go. Lane change to the right. This is where you really got to watch your speed because we're a little heavier than a regular car. So we'll pick up speed pretty quick. And we're still stopping our car length, a car and a half length from the car in front of us. Now we'll keep on going.
What does the sign say about the bridge height?
The sign says, what does that sign say? 13.6.
Eight.
It actually says 13.8.
And make a right turn here.
Make a right turn here. All right. No cars. Get in the right lane. And we have a pretty good right turn here. So we'll have to go out a little in the next lane. There's no traffic coming. And we watch our curves. There we are. As a truck, we're always going to go into the next lane. We're a little bit longer than everyone else. So we're always going to take over another lane. So when you make your left and right turns, you're going to have to watch for vehicles, oncoming vehicles in the other lanes. Watch our red light, and we're going to stop behind the white line once again.
And turn right here.
Turn right. Remember, right turn, right lane, left turn, left lane. You'll do good.
Make a lane change to the left.
Going to the left lane, no cars. All the way or right in the middle?
One more.
One more?
Then we will turn left.
Turning left.
At the lights. Turn left here.
Left here. Ooh, this is a skinny road. Skinny, skinny. But we're right in between the lines. Arrow. Got a car stopped in front of me and a pedestrian walking in front of me. Both sides of my truck for traffic. Behind the white line. Look both ways. Also in a residential area, if there is no speed limit sign posted, the speed limit is 25.
I used to live here.
Did you?
Yes.
Those are nice houses.
It's a little bit dangerous street.
Yeah. A lot of activity.
Yeah.
usually they don't give students streets like this to go down because it is a lot of activity.
Yeah.
Yeah, where you live at now is a lot better.
Yes.
Here's a school zone coming up. And school zones are 25. Two lanes and we get in the right lane. There's my sign to end the school zone.
You pass on the yellow light, which is fine. Take the left lane. And we will turn left at the lights.
Left at the lights. I believe once you take the intersection, then you can keep going on the intersection. But if I would have took it and it was yellow and then I entered it, I would be wrong.
Take the next exit, 75 South Cincinnati.
We'll move over to 75 South. And there's no slow down for a turn. Go all the way out, hand over hand. We take the curve, we're taking the high side of the curve, staying to the left as we go to the right, so we can stay in the middle of our lane.
Take the exit 54B, next right.
Next right. We need to come over.
keep this one, it's two lanes.
Oh, it sure is, an outside lane, that's even better. The truck should always be in the outside lane.
Then we will keep the left on here.
Okay, stay left. So we need to be down to about 40. Construction zone, so we'll have to be careful. Merging lane on the right. Watch for traffic. Watch for construction. Solid white line is done. We've got our blinkers on, going to the right. Wait for all the traffic to go by so we don't impede any traffic or cut anyone off. Merge to the right.
Change to the right.
Make a lane change to the right. We've got traffic there, so we're going to hold off. We don't want to impede traffic. Looks like they're slowing up and letting us get in, so I'm going to move over to the right.
Take the next exit at the right.
Okay. Turn on my signal to go to the right. I see there's a sign that says 25, so I need to not, I just need to slow way down, but I don't want to do all my slowing down on the highway.
And we will turn left here.
And then we'll go to the left. Going to stay closer to the right side of the lane. Then we stop our car length or a car and a half length from the car in front of us. We got a green light. Keep on going. I got my hands at the 9-3 and I know to go hand over hand on the turn. I gotta watch the traffic beside me because I don't want them to cut me off.
Keep it on this lane.
Okay, I'll stay on this lane. We're hitting a school zone, but the lights aren't flashing, so we can keep our speed. But if it was, we'd have to drop down to 20 miles an hour. But I am keeping an eye on kids, because if there's kids, I will slow down.
And we will make a left turn at the lights.
Left turn at the lights. We park behind the white line and stop.
You can go.
Cut the green arrow. And hand over hand on my turn. Stay in the left lane here. Check my mirrors. I'll stay in the left lane because the right lane is ending. Bumpy road. Definitely got to keep a tight hand on the steering wheel. Right now I've got mine at a 9-3.
What does the sign say here?
This is a crosswalk, so you would be aware of the people or pedestrians at the crosswalk and slow down. In fact, there's quite a few. It's letting you know there's another crosswalk up ahead. To correct that, I don't think they would have the right of way. I would think I would just have to slow down and observe that they're there on the crosswalk.
Speed limit here.
Speed limit here is 35. Watch our pedestrian off to the right there. Take the high side of the curve, stake towards the left.
And we will turn left to the school.
Turn on my turn signals, turning left, and I will slow down. Hand over hand on my turns. Watch my left mirror as I make a turn. Make sure I don't hit any curves. Straighten it out. Go straight through the gate.
All right, you can park next to the yellow trailer.
Okay. Check my parking light here. Parking lot. Make sure no one's coming. Watch my cones. it in neutral. Set your brake.
Congratulations, you pass.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good luck, you guys.